Okay, here's the last of our PI detectors that we're going to test. This is an ancient White's PI 1000 Series 2 PI. This does not have a normal, what we consider today to be a normal threshold. It's got a bone phone, kind of a skull cruncher knocker that you put under your wetsuit hood instead of a headphone. I kind of like that actually in the wintertime. You got a full wetsuit and hood on. It's really cold. I actually like it. I still like this detector. I'm a freak, I guess. It's really good at finding big objects. Not so great at finding smaller stuff. Anyway, enough of my talking. Let's put it to the test. You can't adjust the level of this knocker. It's just, it is what it is. Here's our battery test. There's a tune position. Here's our on position. Detector's ready to go. Here's our 7.4 gram, 14 karat ring. Notice the way that the tempo of the knot increases as the ring goes over the coil. This machine, it's a solid 10 to 11 inches on this 7.4 gram ring. As old as it is, you know what? That's not too bad. Same depth on that target as the sand shark. Here's our nickel. You guys may not be able to notice the difference in the tempo like I can. I've used these things a lot, and so I pick up on it maybe more easily. So, see, I could recognize that if I was using the machine. You do have to swing these coils slow, but in the water, I work slow anyway, personally. Nickel, 10, 11 inches. Another thing that I really like about these old PI 1000s is that they are true no motion PIs. They don't detune over the target, so when you're trying to pinpoint something in your serve, it can be a real advantage. Watch. On a normal detector, a modern detector that's not a no motion machine, obviously the threshold disappears and goes back to normal. Once you stop moving the coil, doesn't happen on the PI 1000. Here's our 4 gram yellow metal band. Inches easy. Here's our horsey again. Maybe 5 inches. What you're going to see with this old PI 1000 when we get down to some of the smaller stuff, I don't have no idea what the pulse delay on this old machine is, but it's not going to be sensitive to the smaller stuff, the smaller goals, like the modern machines are. There's no response. That's our 1.1 gram, 14. Excuse me, 10 carat earring. All the other machines that we tested today responded to that. None of them got it deep. None of them got it over 2 inches, I don't believe. But the old PI 1000 just won't get it at all. Pulse delay is too high. Let's see about this. There's a little silver clasp. It does get that. PI 1000 does get that. Not too deep. Our 1 gram earring. Respectable. Seven inches. There you go. I just showed you that one for fun. These aren't available anymore. But if anybody tells you that they're worthless or useless in the field, that you have to have something better, you know what? This machine, as you just saw, is very, very comparable in depth. On what targets we're all going to find most of, and that's or what we want to find most of, and that's average size wedding bands. This whole thing is just as sensitive to average wedding bands as is the sort of sand shark.